さて、始めよう。Warning, there might be puns ahead. I said puns, not buns. Anyways, Japanese, and especially Pokemon, is a veritable cornucopia of buns, puns, so they will be everywhere.
はじめまして、ポケットモンスターの世界へようこそ。
And here we begin, literally. はじめまして is from the verb for to begin, はじめる。But is often said as a greeting when you meet someone for the first time. You can think of it as the beginning of a great new friendship.
はじめまして。
Following that, Okido says some stuff about Pokemon and a Seikai and a Yokoso. But what does it mean?
Yokoso means welcome.
And the he right next to it is no normal he. First off, it is pronounced like e, and more importantly, it is a particle. Particles are seen as frequently in Japanese as Pokemon are in tall grass, and they tell you what words are doing in a sentence.In this case, the e indicates that there is a location or destination being referred to.
ポケットモンスターの世界へ。
So, by adding it onto the end of 世界, we understand that this is the place we are being welcomed to when Okido says,
ようこそ。
But what in the world is a ポケットモンスターの世界? Well, it is the work of yet another particle. The no particle allows the first noun to modify the second noun. 世界 means world, and ポケットモンスター means pocket monster or, you know,Pokemon. So, Pokemon Monster modifies the word Seikai to describe it. It is sort of like putting a name tag on it. Just remember that the final noun is what we are actually talking about, and anything before it only modifies or describes it. A lot of beginners find it easiest to flip the nouns around and add an of between them when translating, so try that if you have some trouble. Put it all together and we get, Nice to meet you. Welcome to the world of Pokemon.
はじめまして。ポケットモンスターの世界へようこそ。私の名前はオーキド。みんなからはポケモン博士と慕われておるよ。
See, I said we would get practice. Using our dictionaries, we can tackle the first part of this easily.
私の名前 is a name of me, or rather, my name.
But what is this ha after it? It isn't a ha at all, actually. Just as the he changed to e,This ha changed its pronunciation to wa in a sort of grammatical mega-evolution to become the mighty particle wa, signifier of sentence topics. And our topic is, as mentioned, the professor's name, which is Okido. Notice that, even though it's a Japanese name, Okido is written in katakana. This is because kids can't read kanji, and katakana helps signify that it's a name, not a word. Remember, katakana isn't always English loanwords. Minna means everyone, and kara is another particle.Kara means from, both in a literally from a place sense and also, as the case is here, a more figurative from so-and-so sense. Pokemon Hakase is pretty straightforward with dictionaries, Pokemon Professor. But what is this to 慕われておるよ? The first part, to, is yet another particle, which acts like a verbal and written quotation. And that last part, it is a verb, but no regular verb. It is a passive form verb in the gerund form with a colloquial form of another verb attached to the end.For us, it's like a tree, and we don't have the karecham yet. As the Japanese say, shikata ga nai, or nothing we can do. We'll have to come back to it, and we will let you know when, except for that end bit there. The oru. Let's talk about that. Old men in Japanese media tend to replace iru with oru. It doesn't mean that the elderly actually speak like that in real life, but they might if they're some sort of radical anime grandpa that cosplays as Master Roshi from Dragon Ball. And iru? That's gonna be one of your best friends.It is the verb for to be, used exclusively for animate objects like people and animals. But how do verbs work? Very simply, there is a positive form, which is just this,
iru.
And then there is a negative form, which is, in this case, inai, which means is not. For instance, if someone asks if your parents are home, you can be a jerk and say inai and slam the door on them. But please don't actually do that. Take note, we replace the iru with nai.Which is all we do for a whole category of verbs called ichidan verbs. For inanimate objects, we use the verb aru, which has the negative form of just nai when speaking casually. Hopefully you figured out that Okido is saying that everyone calls him the Pokemon Professor. If not, no worries, because we've got a whole game to practice ahead of this. Our final translation for this line will be, My name is Okido. Everyone affectionately refers to me as the Pokemon Professor.
私の名前はオーキド。みんなからはポケモン博士と慕われておるよ。 この世界にはポケットモンスターと呼ばれる生き物たちが至るところに住んでいる。
This one's a bit of a doozy, but let's break it down. First, look, another null. But this time, it is not attached to a noun beforehand. It's got a ko. Ko isn't a particle, and is instead used in place of a proper noun. Think of it as the this of Japanese, referring to things close to the speaker. So we're talking about the seikai again, and we're specifying this one, the Pokemon no seikai. Ko has two siblings, so and a, which translate to that and that. The difference is so refers to something close to the person you are talking to, and a refers to something away from both people. Ko no, so no, a no. We've got two more new particles showing up too, ga and ni. Ni behaves a lot like e, and although they're very different, for now we'll use them mostly interchangeably. Just remember that it indicates a place or destination, and it can even be used to discuss more intangible concepts like time. Together with wa, the ni wa specifies that the sentence is actually about where something is, rather than just happening somewhere. Ga indicates a subject of discussion, so it is sort of like wa, but ga isn't really the topic of the sentence, it is sort of a secondary topic. In this sentence, the world as a location is the topic, but the yobareru ikimono tachi are also present and relevant to the discussion. We'll address the differences between these particles more later, but hopefully this helps you roughly understand their usage. So, yobareru ikimono tachi, huh? What's the deal with that? Why is that word so dang long? Well, like most long words we've seen thus far and will see, it is actually different words mashed together like berries in a blender. Instead of two nouns connected by a particle, though, it's actually a verb conjoined to a noun. No particle necessary! It even follows the same pattern that no did, with the word in front modifying the next word. So we've got the passive, to be called, yobareru, modifying living things, ikimono tachi. Unconjugated verbs like this will always end with an u sound, and recognizing them becomes second nature with a little practice. So, let's translate the first part of this sentence. In this world, creatures called Pokemon.
この世界にはポケットモンスターと呼ばれる生き物たちが。
To follow up, we've got itaru tokoro, which looks like a verb modifying a noun, but is actually a phrase that roughly means scattered everywhere, and sundeiru, which is two verbs together, sumu and iru, which mean reside and to be. When together like this, there is a sense that the action is present and continuous. We'll talk about it more later. Altogether, we have,
in this world, creatures called Pokemon live scattered everywhere.
この世界にはポケットモンスターと呼ばれる生き物たちが至るところに住んでいる。
Whew! Notice how the subject of the sentence is the world and Pokemon are the creatures that simply live in it? Behold, the true power of wa and ga.
そのポケモンという生き物たちを人はペットにしたり、処分に使ったり。
Oh man, I recognize so many things here. There is our friend sono referring to those things, and wraps around other descriptive words and affects our primary word. Hey, sono. Also, we've got a nice wa right in the middle, indicating that hito, people, are our subjects this time. Thanks, wa. And look, to came again, but brought its friend iu. Iu is a verb that means to say or to call. In this instance, it is even modifying ikimono tachi. Working backwards, we can figure out what this first bit means. Those living things they call, quote, Pokemon.
そのポケモンという生き物たち。
Keep it coming, To and Iu. Also, I want you to read those katakana out loud. No, not Pokemon. The other ones. Pause if you need time. Figured it out? The word is pet. I kid you not, the word pet in Japanese is petto. Thank you, katakana. Looks like there are some new things too. Like o. It looks like wo, but it's pronounced like o. It's a particle to mark the direct object. The direct object is whatever the verb is acting upon. It means that the verb is describing an action that is happening to the object. In this case, since hito are the subject, hito are performing the verb upon Pokemon. Petto and shobu, which means battle. The Pokemon are the target of the petto in the battling. The shitari will be addressed later, but for now, know that it is listing different things you can do. So if we throw it all in the blender, we come out with, they use those creatures they call Pokemon as pets in competitions with an implied etc.
そのポケモンという生き物たちを人はペットにしたり、勝負に使ったり。私はこのポケモンの研究をしているというわけだ。
We're going to speed up a bit since we've explained a lot of particles, so now we'll just see them in action. We start off with the classic watashi wa combo for a simple I, followed by このポケモンの研究. Kenkyu means research, so he's referring to his research on Pokemon. Shiteiru means doing and is the gerund form of our favorite verb suru. We've got a toyu here too, but nothing has been spoken. Instead, it's being used to encapsulate a summary and then modify our final noun, wake, which is a word not worth splitting your hair over because it just means reason. So, we have a reason for Okido to be interested in Pokemon, and it is doing all of his research on Pokemon. The da is pretty simple, though you may know it better by its polite formal form, desu. Desu and da are sort of the closest you'll get in Japanese to saying is or are, but nowadays people drop them a lot when they aren't being polite. It's still easy to understand what's going on without them. Some people do this in English. It's most prominent in African American vernacular English. You know, where you at? You probably say similar things without even realizing it, no matter where you're from. In this case, although the da is usually dropped, it can be added on the end to emphasize a point. This is Okido's reason. So, as for me, my reason for being interested in Pokemon is that I'm doing this Pokemon research. 私はこのポケモンの研究をしているというわけだ。では、はじめに君のことを教えてもらおう。では is frequently seen at the beginning of sentences and is like saying, well then. It helps the conversation to shift gears. We notice はじめに, which should remind you of はじめまして and はじめる. We're starting from the beginning of something. 君のこと refers to you and your vague and tangible thing. You know, you can't hold it, because it's not there. But it's still your thing. The thing that you do. Your thing. You keep doing your thing, Julie! 教えてもらおう is, once again, a bit beyond the scope of our intro, but is an invitation to let him know about something. Using our sweet O skills, we know that the something he wants to know about is our thang! So our translation is, well then, first of all, tell me about yourself. では、はじめに、君のことを教えてもらおう。君は男の子かな?それとも女の子? When you see a ka at the end of the sentence, it means it's a question. So, 君は男の子かな? is asking if 君は you are an 男の子, boy. The na emphasizes a degree of uncertainty. それとも has the return of our friend それ, which means that, and altogether comes to mean or. Okido is contrasting his first question, which それ refers to, with the second question. Are you an 女の子, or girl? We don't need another ka, because it's obviously a question. Are you a boy, I wonder, or a girl?
君は男の子かな?それとも女の子?
君の名前は? You should be able to figure this one out on your own. Pause the video and try.
君 means you, 名前 means name, the no connects them. So we have name of you, or your name. Then wa? We have a subject, your name, but nothing else. It's a little strange, but by leaving the end of the sentence off, he's inviting us to finish it for him. Lazy bum. Do your own work for once. So, in the end, we have, your name is, but we'll see it translated as what's your name a lot too, because one-to-one translations just don't always sound correct.
君の名前は? Redto to yundana.
Fumu is just the way Japanese people write out, Japan doesn't have many syllables, so they have to MacGyver them together sometimes. Given that, take a crack at translating the rest of this sentence too. Our name is gonna be Red, because we're suckers for tradition. Toyu are here too, to quote it and say that it's called that, and then Da is emphasizing the point. Da brought his friend N along, but we're gonna come back to that. So your name is Red.
Red to yun da na. Koitsu wa watashi no mago.
We've got ko again, basically sewn into the noun itself. Ko gets up to all kinds of weird business. It is indistinguishable from the rest of the word this time. No longer the ko we have come to love, but an alternate timeline ko that has become its own word with a sweet cyborg body part called itsu. Together, they create koitsu, which is a very informal way of addressing a third person, like saying this guy or this dude. To not seem rude, you should use この人 or this person. But in video games, there are no rules, man. Then we jam a watashi and a no and a mago or grandchild all together, and we get my grandchild.
Koitsu wa watashi no mago.
This fellow here is my grandchild. Who translated that to fellow? Like, she's pretty clearly a chick.
Kimi no osananajimi de ari, raibaru de aru.
Osanajimi? Okay, I can't find that word in the dictionary, which means... Lesson time. Break down words you don't know. Okay, I know that osanai is an adjective, which means very young. But osanajimi... Let's look up jimi. Maybe that'll give us a clue. Okay, so here we go. It either means simple jimi or nutrient jimi. Yeah. No. No, that's not working. Okay, wait. Osanana jimi, which means childhood friend. Okay, now I feel silly. Lesson to us all. Always read the whole word. Let's move on. We've got de'aru popping up here. Twice. I've mentioned ichidan verbs earlier, where you conjugate by lobbing off the final ru entirely, but de'aru is another type of verb, godan. It's conjugated in the stem verb form by swapping the final vowel of the syllable, which always ends in an u sound, from an u to an e, creating a verb stem. So we go from de'aru to de'ari. Stem form verbs can be used to make a statement and then followed up with another statement before finishing the sentence, sort of like adding a comma. De'aru is a different way of saying desu. It's used on formal documents or by old people. He's your childhood friend and your rival.
Kimi no osananajimi de'ari, raibaru de'aru. Namae wa nante itta kana?
Check out that He's pausing to think. It's like saying or. So we start with namae, which means name, and is the subject, and we end with itta, which is the past tense form of iu, which means to say. So he's saying our rival's name is nante, right? Wrong. Nante is a form of nani, which translates as what. It can also mean how, but we'll translate it as what did you call him? The ka after the verb tells us it's a question, like verbal punctuation, and the na is giving him space to think about the question, making him appear more thoughtful than a grandfather who forgot his own grandson's name. About his name. What did you call him?
Namae wa nante itta kana?
As long as we have the opportunity, I'd like to name him Little Nutrient Jimmy. But that won't fit.
Soda. Omoidashita zo. Gurin toyu namae da.
Soda. It's like, of course. Intonation means everything with this, though. Just like, of course. Of course. Omoidashita is another past tense verb, meaning to remember. It's actually a compound verb. Omou is to think, and it's converted to its noun stem form, just like aru was earlier. The second, dasu, is to take out or reveal. Together they describe when you remember something, suddenly! Hence, the verbs being mashed together with no space. There's no time between the remembrance and it jumping out at you, like some sort of verb double battle. Also, look at how toyu works with namae just as it did with wake earlier, modifying the noun to express a more complex idea, like gluing two pieces of paper together. Of course, I remembered. Green is his name.
Soda, omoidashita zo. Green toyu namae da. Reddo, iyoiyo kore kara kimi no monogatari no hajimari da.
This is a veritable treasure trove of things we've been talking about through this video. Try translating them all on your own.
Iyoiyo means finally or soon enough, beyond doubt. And korekara is used to mean from now on or from this moment.
You can get a sense of that just from thinking about putting kore and kara together. We haven't seen kore on its own yet, but it is similar to the kono, sono, ano we saw earlier. It can be used without another noun to help it out. So we have kore, sore, and are, which are this, that, and that over there. Altogether, red. No doubt from here on, it's the beginning of your story.
Reddo. Iyoyo, kore kara, kimi no monogatari no hajimari da.
夢と冒険とポケモンの世界へ。Oh, to. We must be quoting things, right? Except we aren't. At all. To, when used like this, is actually listing things together, like the word and. Yume to boken. Dreams and adventures. And an extra to on the end suggests even more awaits us. E is left dangling here, but since it suggests a destination, we can assume we are going somewhere. Dreams and adventures and more. Let's go to the world of Pokemon!
Yume to boken to Pokemon no seikai.
Let's go!
And just as Olkido suggests, join us next time as we head towards the exciting world of Pokemon and Japanese. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe and give us a like if you enjoyed the video, found it useful, or would just like to join us on our adventure. Be sure to let us know in the comments which starter we should choose. Fushigidane, or Bulbasaur, Hitokage, Charmander, or Zenigame, Squirtle, and never be afraid to ask questions. Mata ne!